happy in my marriage and nothing. I'm fed up with that weapon, but if my marriage begins to go to UT, or something like that. If you just allow me to go to UT. Yes. Do we have an RT?
Usage strategies and the better usage of metrics. So see that there are four hypotheses for the research question for method affecting usage of iMetrics. And in this study, we try to see the academic discipline and seniority, which is the years of experience as a researcher, as a mediator affecting this study. So, in order to answer all the four research questions, a questionnaire was developed. And these are the measurements for each research question. So in this study, awareness is assessed as being hard, seen or read about traditional metrics and amateur. For example, survey instrument, we are having error hard, seen or read of the following amateur, and we give them the list of metrics in measuring research outputs. The familiarity, like it's assessed as how familiar do they consider themselves with those metrics. Right, with the 5.6, not that familiar, it's really familiar. So for the usage, there are two approaches to measurement, frequency and current usage. Frequency is how often do they use those metrics. Current usage is the last time they use. Reason why we ask this question is because we can find out with their engagement as well. Like for example, sometimes they are aware of it and use it. But the last time they use was 2 years ago. So they don't really engage with some specific metric as well. So it's all by definition as well. And of course, who are aware of it, and what are the reasons for using them, we are finding out the hindrances also. Okay, for the methodology, our approach is an online survey with email evaluation. So first, the researchers from our project send the evaluation email to the researchers among their personal network, asking them to answer and distribute among their fellow researchers as well. And of course, the target group is the researchers around the world. And I think approval institutional review board of NTU has been approved in July 2016. And so the data collection started in August. And the collection period is from August to end of this year, December 2016. So for the sampling, let me show you the pictures. There are total 6 regions, North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, and Oceania. So the total target sample is 100 faculty and 100 researchers from each region. So total targeted respondent is 1,200 from 6 regions. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, I would like to share some preliminary from the responses that we have been collected so far from the 4 weeks data collection, which is from the first week to last week of August. And the data collection is still ongoing now. So the findings here still cannot be concluded right now. We have received 60 responses from the 4 weeks data collection, but after training for the analysis, we have 41 researchers. Currently, it only represents Asia, but hopefully we can compare with Europe after the conference. But, and Australia will be a challenge. So these are the sample demographics from the office data collection. Currently more from the social science background and more faculty. Okay, regarding the awareness of traditional metrics, like we give them the list of those metrics, not surprisingly, gender impact factor is the most relevant metrics, followed by the total number of citations. And here we try to see the different level of metrics, like the journal level, article level, author level, and institutional level metrics. Journal impact factor is the most aware metrics among the journal level, while the total number of citation is the most aware in article level metrics. But among author level metrics, H index is the most aware metrics. So this is the awareness by professional level. Commonly the awareness and by academic discipline, yeah, currently more from the social science background. And this is the awareness and usage of traditional metrics. So this blue line is the awareness, and this pink pattern is the usage. For example, out of 36 who are aware of channeling effect, 36 researchers really use it. So it's similar for the other metric as well. Right. For the awareness of metrics, currently number of active views and downloads is the most aware metrics so far. Okay, grouping for the metric is a bit different from the traditional metric. Here we adopted the categories proposed in the meta-analysis paper based on the framework from Hodgson. And there are three categories, SSX, which includes the usage events and capture events, for example, viewing or downloading the article, following the researchers. Appraisal as an event which include mentioning and social events, for example, like the social network, mentioning the blog posts, and apply as which includes the citation events. So interestingly, usage event, usage metric is the most aware metric in SSS. Among appraisal at number of likes in social networks is the most aware metrics, followed by the number of clicks and likes. Similarly, this is the awareness by the professional level, currently more from the faculty, and the awareness by the academic discipline, more from the social science right now. Okay, this is the usage of metrics. Usage is a bit low for metrics so currently, but it's too early to conclude it right now. But in the later, the results will be more interesting with more data and more diverse sample. Okay, when we ask about what do you usually do to promote your research? As you can see here, the top three ways are in traditional ways. Like present my work in conferences like this, publish journal articles, papers, and link up with other researchers from similar fields. But you can also see the potential of using academic social networking sites as more than half of the researchers participated in academic social networking sites like the Academia, ADU, ResearchGate. Okay, so these are some preliminary findings from the 4 weeks data collection. So in the future, when we get more data with more diverse sample, we will try to see all these for both traditional metrics and ametrics and see whether there are statistically significant differences among different professional levels, academic disciplines, and region as well. Right? For research question 1, 2, and 3, for research question 4, multiple regression analysis will be used to investigate for research question 4, after controlling the variables, academic discipline and seniority, which is years of experience as researchers. So, after collecting all the data, we believe we could initiate and find out some meaningful and insightful findings for the researchers. So, we invite everyone here to visit our project website. This is the shopping URL of our project website. And share our survey with your fellow researchers. And researchers, please participate in the survey also. And I need some handouts at the tables outside with the candies from Singapore. So you can find your survey there also. Okay, so this then is part of the project, a metrics, rethinking and exploring new ways of measuring research, funded by the National Research Foundation, Prime Minister's Office, and this is a 3-year funded project. And this is some funded details of our project. Our principal investigator is Professor Tan Ying Lun, and Dr. Mojic is a research fellow from our project and myself, and our research center and our project website. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you very much. Thank you. I know we understand that this community or aware of amateur. So like when we share among the world, like among your colleagues and your colleagues with your colleagues, then think